From self-driving cars to electric vehicles, automobiles are becoming more technologically advanced, and there's a shortage of workers who have the diverse skills needed to keep them on the road. Allie Rogin visited one college focused on training the next generation of the automotive industry, including many people who may have once thought there wasn't a place for them there. It's part of our series, Rethinking College.
Okay, guys, for this assignment, we're going to be tearing down the engines, much like you guys are.
At Weber State University in Layton, Utah, it's no coincidence that the automotive program shares a building with computer science.
We have autonomous vehicles now. We have adaptive cruise control. We have full-on hybrid and full-on electric vehicles now. So the old days of just being able to pick up a wrench and work on your car are falling farther and farther behind.
Pop the valve cover off.
Weber State instructor Cade Kroger trains his students for the cars and the jobs of the future.
You are no longer just your average mechanic that's diagnosing base engine concerns. You are IT. You are an engineer. You are a tech expert at this point.
Weber has been keeping students on the cutting edge of the auto industry since 1922, not long after Henry Ford launched the Model T. The university works with companies like Toyota, GM, and Chrysler to make sure students are learning the most in-demand skills. Many students already work in the field and can translate their professional certifications into credits towards an associate's degree. They can stop there or keep going or come back later for their Bachelor of Science in Automotive Technology.
Fundamental knowledge about their particular field is important to us, and we build that up. But we build it up in a kind of a gradated or stackable way so that students can earn degrees and credentials as they move along.
Brian Regu is the Associate Dean of the College of Engineering, Applied Science, and Technology.
It seems like this hybrid approach to higher education is really well geared to this national moment that we're in.
It requires the university to be attuned to what the needs are out there, and you get that information from the industry partners, and then you make the curriculum kind of fit those needs. And that's not an easy thing to do in a university.
One of the biggest needs is the workforce. According to one study, the U.S. auto industry will need more than 300,000 new auto techs over the next 4 years to keep up with demand. Many of those jobs will need to be more technical than mechanical, making it an opportune time for the horsepower industry to rethink manpower.
Women make up about half the American workforce, but only about a quarter of the automotive industry. Experts say that's a missed opportunity.
I think there are a lot of fantastic women out there, a lot of brilliant women that are in other industries that we are missing.
Jessica Slater is the department chair of Weber's automotive program.
Where would the automotive industry be now if those women had been a part of it? If maybe they had entertained a STEM or an engineering field, where would we be now? It's a curious thought. I think we would be somewhere else entirely.
Today, women are a little over 10% of the undergrad auto program at Weber, and the college hopes to boost those numbers, in part by offering college-level courses to students at 16 local high schools.
We want to get in front of these young women, again, before any preconceptions are developed on, you know, well, this is what I'm capable of doing because I'm a woman. We want to get to them when they're 12 years old and they think they can do whatever a boy can do because they can.
It can be easy for young girls to lose that attitude. Luckily, 20-year-old Delaney Long held on to it.
Since I was young, my dad always worked on cars and stuff like that. And he would actually try and show my brother everything and get him into it. So I just tagged along and I enjoyed it more than my brothers.
You're a woman going into potentially a very, right now, male-dominated industry. How do you feel about that?
At first, it was really intimidating, to be honest. But I do feel welcome here. It's fun to show, like, the boys what's up kind of thing.
Not just the boys, her father too.
But it's also fun, like, teaching him some things I've learned here that he didn't know. He's shocked, but proud of me, for sure.
But attitudes take longer to change than tires. A 2020 survey of the auto industry found that 91% of female respondents believed there was a bias towards men for leadership positions. Only 47% of men felt that way. But Weber alum Beth Mia, who now works for the Cummins Engine and Generator Company, says the industry has improved since she started out 2 decades ago.
I couldn't get a job turning wrenches when I first started out in the automotive industry, even though I had more experience than some of my male counterparts. It's obviously a very, very different world. You know, I mean, I graduated from Weber State in like 2004. I think that, you know, just the assumptions that females shouldn't be there is gone.
But Mia says she still deals with sexism in the industry.
Everywhere I go, they usually assume I'm, you know, the marketing girl or the secretary that's helping. And then I get up and I'm presenting the technical information. I always feel that I have to prove myself when my male counterparts can walk up and they just listen. I have to kind of show them why I'm there.
So Mia is paying it forward, speaking when she can to younger students who are curious about the automotive field.
It would have been nice for me to see a female instructor. You know, that would have been encouraging. As cheesy as it sounds, anywhere I can actually appear and be a female is a good thing.
Cade Kroger says the industry would benefit from more women joining.
I have found that our female students, the women in the industry, approach diagnostic in a very unique way, and they end up being great at solving problems.
Plus, these days, the auto industry isn't just looking for gearheads.
Much like the days of old, we still get the students that love automotive for the horsepower, the loud noises, what some students end up coming to the automotive industry in the first place. But the other side of that, though, too, is now I have a lot of students that are interested in IT, that are still interested in cars, or interested in battery design.
Jessica Slater says there's more opportunity in automotive than outsiders realize.
There's a misconception. If you go into automotive, you're just going to be a grease monkey. That's all you're good for. And that is entirely inaccurate. There are so many channels and avenues for this industry that people just don't know about.
That's why Weber State is working to change stereotypes about the industry and the people who work in it. For the PBS News Hour, I'm Allie Rogin in Layton, Utah.